Hi students, so next topic is UQ potential surface. It is important 2 mark and 3 mark question answer. Okay, so what is in by UQ potential surface? Here it is a surface on which all the points are same electric potential. Okay students, in question itself there is having the answer UQ potential. UQ potential surface means it is a surface on which all the points are the same electric potential is called equipotential surface. Okay, for the point charge we consider, for the point charge this equipotential surface is considered as a concentric sphere. Okay students, listen to me. In a note I can draw the diagram in 2 dimensions only, so you can understand in 3 dimensions it is a sphere. Okay, so for the point charge here the equipotential surface is concentric a sphere. So in this sphere we consider the point A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Here all the one having the radius is same. Here it has a radius is R. So in this same radius we consider the different point. In all the point it has the electric potential is the same. Okay students, are you understand about this? Okay, like here we consider the different sphere. Suppose here we consider one sphere, it has a radius is R1. This R1 is smaller than the R, means here in this part all the point having the electric potential is the same, but this electric potential is not same with the electric potential at a point A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay, so here this is a electric potential, equipotential surface. So from this concept easily you can understand this. Here each equipotential surface is on having the same electric potential. Each spherical surface is a equipotential surface. But the value of potential, are different. Here it have the electric potential, it is not same with the electric potential at a point A. Okay, so here the each spherical surface are equipotential surface, but here each spherical surface having different electric potential. Okay students, right? So like here we are consider for the uniform electric field. Suppose we are consider one of the space, it has a uniform electric field like this. Suppose if you are considering, so uniform electric field means in this type of uniform electric field we take this equipotential surface. This equipotential surface is form a set of parallel surfaces. This surface having the plane, that plane is always normal to the electric field. This is called equipotential surface. So for the uniform electric field, the equipotential surface form a set of plane surfaces is always normal to the electric field. Okay students, okay, you can see the diagram in your book, that is clearly given. So now we are going to discuss about this, the properties of the equipotential surface. So in a equipotential surface The work done is always zero. For the equipotential surface, the work done is always zero. Because the work done is calculated by using the formula of W is equal to Q into difference between the potential difference. Suppose we consider the two potential surface A and B, means we can take VA minus VB. Already we know for the equipotential surface, the electric potential at a point A, the electric potential at a point B, both are same. So VA minus VB is equal to zero. So the work done is always zero. That is the first point. Next point, here the electric field is normal to one equipotential surface. If it is normal, the surface is normal to the electric field. If it is not normal, then there is a component to the field is parallel to the surface. Then the work must be done to move a charge between two points on the same surface. This is a contradiction. Therefore, the electric field must always be normal to the equipotential surface. Okay, students? So, from this concept, we can write the electric field is always P normal to equipotential surface. These are the properties of the equipotential surface. Okay, students, next topic, we are going to give the relationship between electric potential and electric field. Already at the starting, we discussed about the electric field, and now itself we discussed about the electric potential. Okay, so we are going to give the relationship between the electric potential and the electric field. So for this, we consider a point charge, and we consider another one positive charge. That positive charge, it is moved from the finite distance. It is moved from the one distance to another distance. It is against the point charge. Okay, so we need to turn the work to move the positive charge from this point to this point. From this point to this point, we need to move towards the plus Q, means we need to turn the work. The amount of work done is notable at a TW. So here we consider the point charge, there is also having the electric field. So we are turn the work against the electric field, and there is a positive charge, here is also positive charge. So there is experience electrostatic force, that is one of the repulsive force. So against the repulsive force, we are done the work. So we can write this amount of work done, dW is equal to minus E into dx. Okay, we can write. Already at the time of introduction, we discussed about this. There is the amount of work done against the force, electric force, electrostatic force, that is a dW is equal to minus E into dx. So like this, in this electric potential, we know that what is in the electric potential, the amount of work done to move the unit positive charge from one point to another point. There is also having electric potential. So we are taking this electric potential, means according to this concept, we can write the dV here, this type of amount of work done is equal to electric potential difference. Electric potential difference. So we can write dV is equal to dW. Okay, students, this is the amount of work done against the electrostatic force. So what is the meaning for electric potential? Electric potential means the amount of work done to move the unit charge from infinity to the point. From infinity to the point is called electric potential. So this amount of work done is stored as energy, that is called electrostatic potential energy. So this electrostatic potential energy is also equal to this amount of work done. So we can take the electrostatic potential difference, that is electric potential difference, is equal to dW. So by using this concept, we can write dV is equal to minus E into dx, means what is the values of the E? E is equal to minus dV divided by dx. Okay, so this is a relationship between the electric field and electric potential. So the electric field
is the negative gradient of the electric potential. According to this equation, the electric field is the negative potential gradient. Negative potential gradient. Okay, students? Okay. So, from this we can write this E vector is equal to, so we can write this is minus into, what is the dV divided by dx? It can be written as dou V divided by dou x I cap plus dou V divided by dou y j cap plus dou V divided by dou z k cap. Okay, students, in general we can write the equation for the electric field. Okay, students.